Good day to you all farmers out there. We're calling all farmers to let you listen to Kentucky Gamer here. What we're going to do today is just kind of walk around and check out the new mods today. Yes, we had some coming out, and I figured I would look into them and see what we have. Well, for today, for $24,500, yes, you can have the Super Cube trailer. Not a bad looking trailer. It looks nice in details. It does have few options and everything, and it is made by 4D modding. It will take up 19.5 megabytes. So let's you will find this in trailers. I have many trailers downloaded, unfortunately, because I do love trailers, but that's the way we play the game. We play the game any way we want to, don't we? But let's go over here and find this. Here it is, the Super Cube. It looks like it will carry and haul pretty much anything. Now, it does take up 5 slots. I already own it, so yes. No, it takes 15 slots. My bad. 15 slots to own. After that, every other one is 1 slot. Yes. And all fruit types. So, hay, silage. You can make it into a silage trailer, of course. We do have that option to make it silage trailer. You have your lizard wheels, your 12-board wheels. We'll set up twin radials, twin forestry. It kind of depends on where you're going to be at. The designs is kind of confusing. All options, or you can have standard. You can add a toolbox. Now, I've not discovered exactly what that is. Any info? Yeah, I would appreciate it. You can add brakes. Now, this is something new to the trailers. I have not noticed before and have not tried it out to see how it would work to add brakes. When I did buy this, I just bought it base as it is. Add easy way. Not sure what that is neither. Toolbox and brake. That is nice. Easy way and brake. That would be nice. Easy way and toolbox. And then just add it all while we're here. That's what a person should do. Registration. I found this neat because it is a neat design I've not seen in FS. No registration, or you can go through the tags and look. You can change all your tags here. Yes, that's pretty neat. Gateway, Dublin, Kildore, Kerry, Longford, all kinds of things. I even seen some U.S. tags on here earlier. And I just found it very interesting. Ontario, Quebec, we're out of Canada now. Belgium, Germany, Denmark, France, Italy. Yes, that's just a very cool aspect if someone wants to do it. Of course, your rim colors. You can change all of your rim colors that you want. A wide variety of anything you want. Yes, just to mix and match some. But, to go back in the main colors, a wide variety. I can't believe it, the colors that you can actually make this one. It's unusual but they're getting better at it, at doing all kinds of different colors. They're coming up with colors that I wouldn't believe anymore. And your design color. We'll change your unloading gate. Very appreciative. Always like to see the unloading gate actually working. So let's go out and look at this and see if it actually works as it should. I will be using ISM for now just to see how it works. It should work fine. I actually do trust 4D modding with a lot of my mods. They're very good at what they do. We'll go over here and see what all it will hold. Of course, your basic fruits, potatoes and beets and sugar cane seeds, TMR that we use, chaff, silage, yes, it'll run silage, grass, hay, straw, yes, working very well as far as I see. Lime, wheat, yeah, seems to be doing good. But overall, I would say very good mod. I like the looks of it. Seems to handle good. I would like to have tried out the braking system. Now unloading, this is a tilt plus dump. It's very interesting to see. Most of the time when you have the large back opening, that's all they'll do is just push it out. This one opens and dumps at the same time. Okay, we shall carry on. See, next on our list here, what do we have? We have a new plow. Yay, everybody wants a new plow every day, of course. But now this is a package deal that you get, which is a good thing. A package of plows. That's absolutely what we need. More 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 meter plows. That's what we have. But the plows, of course, we will find them under plows. The neat thing was, though, when you download it, you actually get a choice of 3 plows. I found it odd the way they done it, though. For the simple reason, the bigger the plow, the less slots you use. The 3.7 meter plow uses 1, 11, 9 slots. But if you come over to the 2.2 meter plow, it uses 11. I'm not sure why they done it, but they did. But it does have some varieties. We normally cannot paint a plow, but in this one you can. Yes, we can change it. The design color, the wheel, why do we have a metal wheel? Somebody come and explain that to me, just let me know. Does the metal wheel serve a purpose? Yeah, let me know on that. Other than that, I have tried it out, it works fairly good, I have to admit. It does, as you can see, it leaves a very good, nice plowing state. Very nice underneath the work. It works as it should. It does what it should. This can also be used for creating fields. That is a very nice solution to a lot of things. A lot of players have problems with creating fields. But it's not incredibly difficult if you have good equipment to do it with. That is the main thing. But as you can see, it works good. It does pull good. It maneuvers good. This plow is not turnable, however, just to let you know. There is no options to turn the plow. So when you come back on your row, keep your back wheel aligned. So it is. But overall, I give this a good credit on nice mod. I do like it. I appreciate it. Appreciate the modders who come up with this stuff. But I did just see it flip over. That could become an issue. Over here next, we have a fertilizer. very nice looking fertilizer. The Maximus. Interesting name, but I do like it. The Lazarus comes. Lazarus Maximus. It comes from Connect Modding. Connect Modding created this, and of course you will find it in fertilizing. Fertilizing technology way over here. There. 12,000 TH. Capacity is 6,000. Now it will hold your fertilizer. It will hold your manure and the dreaded thing that everyone hates. Yes, because it seems like we go through so much of it. Can anybody name it for me? Everybody knows it. Yes, we have to put lime down. Let's see how wide of a spread it has when we put a little bit of lime on this small little field. That would be nice, wouldn't it? Overall, it is a good little fertilizer. It looks great in detail. You can switch up the insides from carbon to stainless steel. This is made by White Bull Modding. It uses 3.24 megabytes to download, but I would call it well worth it. You have your standard design. Very nice looking mod. You can't change a color. I kind of wish you could, maybe put like a stainless steel or aluminum on it, but you can put expansion on it, make it a little wider. That'd be nice to have. Yes, it would. How many of you farmers are going to load equipment on this? Well, I just so happened to think about that. Can we do that? Well, we'll go find out what you can do if you have the implements on or around or in place where you can strap down your equipment. It does work, and it seems to work beautifully. Now, of course, with all your hook equipment, you could load this right onto the back of a truck now. Hopefully this works right with me. I believe it is. See there? Yes, we have it strapped down. Let's go ahead and load container. Let's see if it stays on there. Well, what do you know? Looky there. It seems to be pulling it right on up. It is absolutely on, and we can drive away. So yes, we do have a flatbed now. I know many of y'all have been really, really wanting this. It seems to be loading and unloading very smoothly. Yeah, it looks to me like it's just a very nice situation. And of course, all of us will come up with several ideas to use this for. I wish you luck, and whatever ideas you come up with, please share them with me. I'm learning things every day with this game, even though I've been playing it for many, many years. With that being said, let's move on to our next popular mod that everyone wants to know about. This is the Challenger MT-600D. Interesting look now, isn't it? It has several things you can do with it when you buy it. It is 19.8 megabytes. It uses, however, 35 slots. Which, okay, we can deal with that. The inside looks very, very nice. Riding in air, all nice and beautiful, ain't we? So let's go check this under the store. In the store, you will find it under large tractors. It being a 600, I figured it is a medium, but no, it is a large tractor. Here we have it. Now, configurations. Just adds your different variants of weights on the front of it. Yes, all of us has been in a problem where you just can't steer, or you just want to do a wheelie down the highway. It's whatever you prefer. That's fine. We can do that too. Row crop is a type of tire I've not really understood yet. It's kind of new to me. You can switch to Lizard, Trailborg, or back to Row Crop. Row Crop I will have to play with and see what this actually does. You have your duals in Row Crop, and them actually look very nice. We have no gap in between the tires. That seems a bit unrealistic in a way. But with the weights and everything, well, we just call them wide tires now, wouldn't we? Fenders, we have no fenders. We have front and rear fenders, wide. Yeah, that looks nice, very nice. I would appreciate that sometimes when you're trying to keep them clean, but you just can't. And as you have noticed, the color changes, nada. We do have different engine setups. You start out with a base of 240 horsepower. You increase it. What do we go to? 265. We can increase it. Hmm, 320. Now we're pushing power. 340. Yes, that'd be nice, now wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. We have to admit, everybody's liking and grinning on this one. Covers. I don't know why they put it in under covers. Basically, all it is changing your designs on the back. You have your U.S. You have your European version. It's your preference and whichever you would like. There's some maps I will run. I like the European version. You do also have a GPS. However, for console users, you know, it's not really important. Ag Leader, you also have that. But overall, a very nice looking tractor. Let's see how it sounds. Very nice sounding running machine. Sounds like it has pretty good power to it. Yeah, we're liking the sound of that. Well, let's just try it here on a big cultivator and see how it does, see how it pulls. Hopefully it will pull very well because, yeah, frankly, on my own farm, I would be excited to use it. It has one of these engines that sounds like it just keeps on going. Well, we're at 8 miles an hour with a fairly wide cultivator, so yes, we can accept that. There'd be many, many times, yeah, we would use it. Absolutely. So, yes, that confirms all of our mods on this day, October 13th. I hope you enjoyed it. If you don't mind, reach around and smash that like button. I know y'all enjoyed it. Enjoyed to hear me talk. And hopefully we're going to have many more to come. Showing off the mods that we have, and I may do some map previews. I don't know about Let's Play right now. I'm kind of waiting on another map that really takes an interest. But for now, smash that like button. If you have not already subscribed, please subscribe. Thank you very much.